In our daily life, we use a lot of material. Even our food has a lot of variety. Different items also have different taste. In preparing and storing food, we take a lot of care. In this chapter, we will try to understand the reasons for some of them. What sort of food do we eat? Are all of them alike? For example, do they have the same color, taste, etc.? Do you find a difference in the taste of a ripe and a raw fruit? In what ways are they different? What kind of tastes do food substances we eat have? Fruits, vegetables, and other food substances have different tastes. Sweet, sour, bitter, salty, spicy, sweet, sour, bitter, salty, spicy, sweet, sour, bitter, salty, spicy. Do some substances change their state when cooked? Do substances change their taste when added to some other substances? Do some substances change color when added to other substances? Let us do an activity. Take some turmeric powder, add a bit of water to it, and prepare turmeric paste. Rub the turmeric paste on a white paper. Draw a flower on that paper with a pencil. Color the flower with soap water using a brush. Does the color of the flower remain the same when soap water is put on it? We notice here the turmeric changes color when soap water or lime water is added to it. It is possible that some other substances also change their color. Let us do an activity. Take a turmeric paper piece. Find as many of the substances given in the following graphic. Put them on the turmeric paper one by one. You could try using other substances around you as well. Let us do an activity. Take solutions of some juices of fruits, vegetables, cold drinks, and various solutions, and test them with blue and red litmus papers. List out the results. Substance: orange. Blue litmus turns red. Tomatoes: blue litmus turns red. Baking soda: red litmus turns blue. Mineral water: no change in litmus. Vinegar: blue litmus turns red. Shampoo: red litmus turns blue. Washing soda: red litmus turns blue. Cucumber: blue litmus turns red. Grape juice: blue litmus turns red. Soap: no change in litmus. The substances that turn blue litmus to red are acidic in nature. The substances that are soapy to touch and turn red litmus to blue are basic in nature. Some of the substances given in the list did not change the color of either blue or red litmus. These are said to be neutral in nature. Let us do an activity. Classify the above substances into the following categories from the above observation. Acidic substance, basic substance, neutral substance. Under acidic substances, orange, tomatoes, vinegar, cucumber, and grape juice. Basic substances, baking soda, shampoo, washing soda. Under neutral substances, mineral water, bathing soap. Indicators. The paper strips, like litmus paper strips, change color based on the nature of the material put on them. These are all indicators. They tell us whether a substance is acidic or basic. They are used extensively in studying substances and their properties. Acidic nature. You may have experienced a burning sensation when bitten by an ant. The sensation is due to the presence of formic acid that the ant releases. Let us see some substances and the acid present in them. Acetic acid, vinegar. Citric acid, lemon, orange. Butyric acid, stale cheese. Lactic acid, milk, curd. Oxalic acid, spinach, tomato. Malic acid, apples. Tannic acid, tea. Oleic acid, olive oil. Stearic acid, fats. Tartaric acid, grapes, tamarind. Palmitic acid, palm oil. Ascorbic acid, amla. Uric acid, urine. Basic nature. The substances which are soapy to touch are basic in nature. Some substances that contain bases that we use in our daily life. For example, soap. Lime water has the base calcium hydroxide. Glass cleaners have ammonium hydroxide. Soaps have sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide as a base. Milk of magnesium has magnesium hydroxide as a base. Let us do an activity. Burn a small piece of magnesium ribbon by holding it with tongs. Collect the white ash and dissolve it in a little water. Touch the solutions formed and test this solution with blue litmus and red litmus. Oxides of magnesium, when dissolved in water, form magnesium hydroxide. Similarly, oxides of potassium and sodium form potassium hydroxide and sodium hydroxide when dissolved in water. All these are basic in nature. They would be soapy when touched. Have you heard about acid rains? Do you know what acid rains are? Acid rains are the combination of carbonic acid, sulfuric acid, and nitric acid with rainwater. Acid rains causes damage to buildings and to our skin. Industrial waste gases contain sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxide, and carbon dioxide. When they get mixed with moisture, they change to acids. Acid rains are also witnessed in our state in Visakhapatnam district. Let us do an activity. Take some lemon juice in 2 test tubes and add eggshells to 1 test tube and some pieces of marble to another. Bring a burning matchstick near the test tubes. What happens? The fire puts off. These are due to the release of some gas. Pass the gas into lime water. We could see some bubbles evolved. The lime water turned milky white. It shows that the gas evolved is carbon dioxide. We have seen that neutral solutions have no effect on indicators. We have also seen that acids and bases have opposite effects on indicators. If we add excess base, caustic soda, to acidic solution like hydrochloric acid, it converts into base. Similarly, we can change a base into acid. When acids and bases are mixed in definite proportions, they give a neutral solution. We learn more about neutralization in higher classes. Fertile land, organic manures. In recent years, the use of chemical fertilizers has increased. Though the use of chemical fertilizers increases production, it changes the nature of the soil. Some fertilizers increase the acidity of the soil and some its basicity. Thus, use of natural organic manure is becoming more preferred these days. Salts. We have seen in the process of neutralization, both the acidic and the basic qualities are destroyed. Actually, when an acid and a base are mixed, a chemical reaction takes place and salts are produced. For example, by neutralizing hydrochloric acid solution with caustic soda solution, a salt, sodium chloride, is produced. Production of salt depends on the quantity of acid and base by proportion in a very specific manner. Let us do an activity. Test the following salt substances with red litmus and blue litmus papers. Salts which change blue litmus to red are acidic salts, and salts which change red litmus to blue are basic salts. Some salts affect neither blue nor red litmus. These are called neutral salts. Salt substance, copper sulfate. Effect on blue litmus paper. Changes to red. Effect on red litmus paper. No change. Common salt. Effect on blue litmus paper, no change. Effect on red litmus paper, no change. Sodium carbonate. Effect on blue litmus paper, no change. Effect on red litmus paper, changes into blue. Let us do an activity. Classifying salts. Collect some salt substances with the help of your teacher. Make their salt solutions. Test the salt solutions with blue litmus and red litmus papers. Classify these salts as per your observation. Acidic salts, copper sulfate, basic salts, sodium carbonate, and neutral salt, common salt. Our body needs many types of salts. We lose some salts through excretion, so sweat is salty.